What was it, Dorothy, that you were looking for in the insulin structure? Can I put...
It's what it was, you know. The,
yes.
I mean, how the peptide chain... And of course, it was a very important step for us when Sanger found
the sequence.
We didn't, in any sense, need to know it for our analysis, but it cheered us up like anything to see our distribution of atoms conforming to that expected from Sanger's sequence.
Yes. Now, when the structure came out in 1969, you, if I remember very well, Dorothy, and others of us, spent 2 days, I think, interpreting that map. And when the structure was complete, we had the details, really, of a hexamer.
Yes.
Which I don't know what you thought about at the time, Dorothy, but it was, I think, a very beautiful structure.
Yes.
And it, in a sense, one of the first things we did, we used to think about Svedberg's experiments, which were telling us that we had different conditions, hexamers and dimers.
Well,
and you remember, can you remember looking inside this hexamer for the fundamental dimer?
Yes. I'm also sort of thinking of the fact that in the first letter to Nature I wrote about those early measurements, I measured, of course, the molecular weight of the rhombohedral unit cell, and this contained 6 insulin molecules. It had a molecular weight of about 36,000. So my first suggestion was that the insulin molecule might have a weight of 36,000. Mm. And this led to a very irate letter from Freudenberg, who was the major chemical worker on insulin at the time, saying insulin is much smaller than this. It's at least not more than 11,000, and maybe even less. And Svedberg only measures a particle weight in his measurements in the ultracentrifuge. And this was all absolutely correct and proved by the final structure analysis. But I replied politely to Freudenberg, I think, at the time. But I didn't see Freudenberg until really very late, when I was elected a member of Leopoldina, which is an academy, a very old scientific academy. It's older than the Royal Society. And it was essentially an academy for all German-speaking peoples. And to my surprise, when I went to the first meeting that I went to of the Leopoldina, I found that it was, there were present East and West Germans, and they got away with going on meeting together in the Leopoldina all the way through this episode of the partition of Germany. And the first person I met on the steps of the Leopoldina as I was going in was Freudenberg himself, and I had structure of insulin in my hand.